Many systems of scientific and societal interest consist of a large number of interacting components. The structure of these systems can be represented as networks, where network nodes represent the components and network edges the interactions between the components. Network analysis can be used to study how pathogens, behaviors, and information spread in social networks, having important implications for our understanding of epidemics and the planning of effective interventions. In a biological context, at a molecular level, network analysis can be applied to gene regulation networks, signal transduction networks, protein interaction networks, and much, much more. This case study first introduces some basic concepts about networks. We'll then write a Python function to generate very simple random graphs. And finally, we'll analyze some basic properties of social networks collected in different rural villages in India. If we wanted to be strict with terminology, we should really distinguish between the terms network and graph. Network refers to the real-world object, such as a road network, whereas a graph refers to its abstract mathematical representation. It's useful to be aware of this distinction, but we'll be using these terms, networks and graph, interchangeably. Let's first define some basic network concepts. Graphs consist of nodes, also called vertices, and links, also called edges. Mathematically, a graph is a collection of vertices and edges, where each edge corresponds to a pair of vertices. When we visualize graphs, we typically draw vertices as circles and edges as lines connecting the circles. There are many concepts that are used to describe graphs. Let's define a couple of them so we have some common terminology. In this picture, this is an example of a vertex, as is this one over here, and this is an edge between these two vertices. Two connected vertices are said to be neighbors. So this vertex, vertex number one, is a neighbor of vertex two, and vice versa. The degree of a vertex is the number of edges connected to it. So the degree of this vertex is one, the degree of this vertex is one, two, three, and so on. A path is a sequence of unique vertices, such that any two vertices in the sequence are connected by an edge. Let's call this vertex three. So a sequence 1, 2, 3 would be a path. That's because vertex 1 and vertex 2 are connected, and vertex 2 and vertex 3 are connected. Intuitively, the path is the path that I've highlighted here. The length of a path is defined as the number of edges in that path. In this example, 1 plus 1, that gives us 2, so the length of the path for node 1 to node 3, or vertex 1 to vertex 3, is equal to 2. Let's look at another path. Let's call this vertex 4 and this 5. The length of the path from 1 to 5 would be 1, 2, 3, and so on. In this case, we're specifically talking about the shortest paths, a path that comprises the minimum number of steps for us to go from vertex A to vertex B. A vertex V is said to be reachable from vertex U if there exists a path from U to V. That is, if there is a way to get from U to V. So for example, looking at this vertex 1, and let's say this one over here, 4, 1 is reachable from 4 because we can get from 4 to 1. And likewise, because in this case the graph is undirected, we also have a path from 1 to 4. A graph is said to be connected if every vertex is reachable from every other vertex. That is, if there is a path from every vertex to every other vertex. In this case, our graph here is connected. If a graph is not connected, it is said to be disconnected. So let's add a couple of vertices here to demonstrate that. We might have vertex 6 and 7 here, and they might be connected to one another, but neither of the two is connected to the rest of the graph. That's why, in its entirety, this graph is disconnected. If a graph is disconnected, it breaks apart naturally into pieces or components. Any component is connected when considered on its own, but there are no edges between the nodes that belong to different components. In this case, we have two components. we have one component over here, and we have our second component, which is over here. And there are no edges from nodes in this component to nodes in this component. The size of a component is defined as the number of nodes in the component. If there are several components in a graph, the largest component, the one having the greatest number of nodes, is called the largest connected component. In this case, the size of this component here is 2. The size of this component is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.